Have you ever gone swimming in the ocean and accidentally taken a big gulp of water? Yuck! It's so salty. But not all water you find in nature is like this. On our beautiful planet Earth, water comes in two flavors: saltwater and freshwater. While most of the water on Earth is the salty variety, today we're going to be exploring the freshwater biome. It's not just nicer for us to drink, many animals agree. If you've ever gone fishing in a pond or watched ducks swimming in a lake, these are just a few of the creatures that call freshwater their home. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. When we say freshwater biome, we're not just talking about the water all by itself. A biome is a place or region on Earth with a specific set of plants, animals, and climate. For example, camels and cacti thrive in the heat and can be found together in the desert biome. Similarly, penguins and seals thrive in the cold and can be found in the Antarctic tundra biome. So what do you think that means for us today in the freshwater biome? We'll take a closer look not just at the places with freshwater, but also the climate and the plants and animals who live there together. The freshwater biome includes any body of water that contains little to no salt, such as rivers, lakes, ponds, streams, and wetlands. Freshwater biomes cover only about 1% of the Earth's surface, but are still incredibly important for life on our planet. They provide habitats for a wide array of species. They're pretty important for us too. More on that later. Freshwater biomes are divided into two main categories: lotic, flowing waters like rivers and streams, and lentic, still waters like lakes and ponds. Whether or not a body of freshwater is flowing or still, it will have an impact on which plants and animals live there. In other words, the animals you find in a pond will probably be different than the ones you find in a river. Are you surprised by this? Think about the adaptations plants and animals would need to live in these different environments, whether that means deeper roots or stronger swimming muscles, and it makes a lot of sense. As we discuss lakes and ponds and rivers and so on and so forth, it's easy to forget that the water in these places is constantly on the move. This movement of water is called the water cycle, and freshwater plays a very important role in it. Where should we start? How about with a magic trick, where water disappears? Well, sort of. This cycle begins with evaporation, where water from lakes, rivers, and wetlands turns into invisible vapor and rises into the atmosphere. As the water vapor cools, it forms clouds in a process called condensation. These clouds eventually release the water back to the earth as precipitation, such as rain or snow. This precipitation replenishes freshwater bodies and groundwater, maintaining the delicate balance of the ecosystem. Rivers and streams transport this water, carrying it across the land and eventually returning it to the oceans. This movement of water is essential for distributing nutrients, supporting plant and animal life, and maintaining the overall health of our planet. Freshwater biomes all have that big thing in common: fresh water. But they're also all a little bit different. This is especially true when you think about their climate, because fresh water can be found all over the world. So the fresh water you find near the poles is much colder than the fresh water you might encounter in the tropics. For example, lakes in Canada can freeze over in the winter, while ponds in the southern United States can be warm year-round. Tropical freshwater biomes, like those in the Amazon basin, stay warm throughout the year and receive a lot of rainfall. Despite these differences, all freshwater biomes have one thing in common: they are not salty like the ocean. That's a really good thing for all the plants and animals that depend on that water to survive. Freshwater plants are essential to the health of these biomes. They provide oxygen, food, and shelter for many aquatic creatures. One of the most common types of freshwater plants is algae. Algae are tiny plants that float on the surface of the water and perform photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process that uses carbon dioxide and water plus the energy of sunlight to power the formation of sugars that the plants use for food. Photosynthesis also produces oxygen, which is not only important for humans, but also all of the other animals living in the freshwater biome. There are also larger plants that live here, like water lilies. Water lilies have roots that anchor them to the bottom of the lake floor, while their broad leaves float on the surface, capturing sunlight. Most people think water lilies are free-floating, but nope. They have roots that run through the water all the way down to the floor. Cattails and reeds are often found along the edges of ponds and marshes. These tall, sturdy plants provide habitats for birds, insects, and a variety of small animals. They also help filter the water by trapping sediments and absorbing nutrients. In rivers and streams, plants like waterweed and moss cling to rocks and logs, providing food and shelter for fish and other animals. The freshwater biome is home to an incredible variety of animals, each adapted to living in the water. Fish are some of the most well-known inhabitants. Species like trout, bass, and catfish are common in many lakes and rivers. These fish have gills that allow them to breathe underwater and are adapted to swim in various water conditions. Amphibians like frogs, toads, and salamanders are also common in freshwater environments. An amphibian is a cold-blooded vertebrate animal that can live both in water and on land. Frogs lay their eggs in water, and the tadpoles that hatch are fully aquatic before transforming into adult frogs that can live both in and out of water. Birds such as ducks, herons, and kingfishers are often seen in freshwater biomes. Ducks paddle on the surface, herons wade in the shallows looking for fish, and kingfishers dive from the air to catch their prey. Invertebrates like crayfish, snails, and dragonflies also play important roles in freshwater ecosystems. An invertebrate is an animal that does not have a backbone or spinal column. Crayfish scavenge the bottom, snails graze on algae, and dragonfly larvae live in the water before emerging as flying adults. Our journey to uncover the secrets of animals in every biome is just beginning, and we need your help. By donating, you'll help us fund our next video series all about animals living in each biome. Support our nonprofit and be a part of this wild adventure. Donate now, linked below. For some of us, it's possible to go explore freshwater in your own backyard. Maybe there's a pond or even a river nearby. If not, we're happy to share some iconic places you could visit to go see these freshwater biomes in action. The Amazon River in South America is the largest river by volume and supports a vast array of wildlife, including piranhas, river dolphins, and the giant anaconda. The Great Lakes in North America are a group of five interconnected lakes that contain 20% of the world's fresh surface water. They are home to diverse species of fish and support millions of people living in the surrounding areas. Lake Baikal in Russia is the deepest and oldest freshwater lake in the world. It holds about 20% of the world's fresh surface water and is home to unique species like the Baikal seal, the only freshwater seal in the world. Try imagining a world without rivers to swim in, lakes to fish in, or wetlands to explore. Earth would be a much less beautiful and exciting place to be. From the tiny algae that produce oxygen to the majestic fish that glide through clear waters, every part of this biome has a job to do on our planet. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.